Hello, my friend, to continue our video series on aquaculture. We will visit New Zealand to check out a mussel farm in a calm water region. Mussels are a popular choice for aquaculture because they are easy to farm and delicious to eat. Here they produce billions of mussels every year. It is considered more productive than land-based farms for sheep or goats. In today's video, I will show you all the details about their mussel farming process. Now let's watch. Let me tell you about the first step of mussel farming. To farm mussels, they start off with the baby mussel, which is called SPAT. They are about the size of a grain of sand. They get either caught in the wild or breed in a hatchery with warm water and the right lighting. The warm water helps to stimulate their mating and reproductive processes, which can be tougher for them in nature. Check it out! These are spats under the microscope. After that, the mussel spats will be kept in these bubbly tanks. And wanna know what they eat at this stage? It's this cool green liquid. Can you guess what that is? The answer is algae. This type of feed is perfect for mussels, both in the hatchery and in the wild. The spats will stay here for a few weeks before they are sifted and moved to an outdoor farm. Here, they will grow to be about 2.5 to 3 centimeters before being taken out to the ocean. These mussels have reached the perfect size and are now ready for the next step. The mussels are stuffed into the net like this, then it's called socking. They are hung on ropes and anchored with floating buoys on the surface of the ocean. This is called the long line system. At the sea surface, the backbone usually extends across about 110 meters and carries the dropper ropes. Let's take a moment to watch this. Depending on the water depth, each rope can be up to 20 meters long, and the backbone can carry a total of 2.5 to 3.5 kilometers of droppers. Mussels also help clean the water. They are filter feeders, which means that they feed by collecting tiny organisms from the water. This means that they do not need any additional feed or fertilizers to grow. After about 12 months, when they reach about 10 centimeters in size, we can harvest them. Let's follow this beautiful process. Once harvested, the mussels will be brought to the processing plant. Here they are processed in different ways depending on their characteristics and the demand. In New Zealand, besides exporting fresh and steamed mussels, they even make protein powder. This is the process of making protein powder from mussels. Mussels are not only delicious, but also packed with nutrients such as protein and polyunsaturated fatty acids. They are low in cholesterol, saturated fats, and trans fats, making them a great addition to a healthy diet and good for heart health. Now, let's see how mussels are packaged for export. New Zealand is one of the largest exporters of mussels in the world. In 2022, they earned $52 million in export revenue from greenshell mussels. The production of mussels doesn't have a big impact on the environment, and the industry's carbon and freshwater footprints are small compared to other protein crops. What's more, mussel farms even provide habitats for other species to thrive, making them a sustainable choice for aquaculture. Now we've come to an end of the video today. I hope you enjoyed and learned something new about mussel farming technique. Don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell icon to get notified of my latest videos. Thank you for watching and goodbye.